Guys, I just want you to remember, this is exactly why I did that video yesterday. That was all puppies and rainbows and smiles and hugs, because I said what? That it wouldn't last. We're gonna cover the drama first, because I'm guessing that's why most of you are here. And then we're gonna jump into tweets, and there's a lot of them, because a lot happened in these two, technically 3 days of competition. So let's just jump into it. The press conference. Let me just, spoiler alert, Alina won the competition. The topic had been touched upon that the girls found out live that it was not going to be a draw, you know, like draw a number or a name from a hat or a box, but instead it was going to be a choose. They were going to choose who they wanted, and Zhenya talked about it in depth about how she found out live that this was the situation and that she was confused about it. So, you know, by instinct, they started choosing their friends, of course. And she had insinuated at a certain point that maybe Yakudin had told Alina a little bit earlier that it was going to be a choose and not a draw. So just keep that in mind. And so today in the press conference, what happens is that it's the end of the press conference, so the host says what she needs to say, which is there are no winners or losers. This was an event that was made specifically to just bring attention to the sport and yada, 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 yada. And while she's saying those things, Alina's, you know, making faces and shaking her head. One of the journalists is like, can Alina say final words? And so Alina does, and she says, there are winners. And those winners are called Red Machine. Her team was called Red Machine. And Zhenya jumped in there and said, there are winners here and there, which has been explained to me in two different ways. One, that they won the most disciplines. And two, that they won the audience award. So there's, you know, winners here and there. There's winners on both sides, essentially. And so Alina responded to that, well, we have the cup. And Zhenya very passive-aggressively said, well, congrats. And Alina very passive-aggressively responded, well, thank you. And this video has just been floating around and people are getting very heated. I laughed for about 10 minutes. I loved it, honestly. It was very passive-aggressive. It basically showed me that what the relationship is, which is there is none, except for when they have to. So that's basically the drama. And I'm just saying it because I feel like it's my duty to tell you the drama. However, it's also my duty to tell you to not propagate and create more drama. I know it's very easy to go and fight with a stranger on the internet and to go attack and put out just more toxicity into this mess, but that's not what we need right now. Both of the girls were petty, both of the girls were passive-aggressive, and both of the girls did not handle it properly. Honestly, what I think is that, you know, it's been 2 days of competition, very intense competition. And that's what happens when you, you know, evolve into a sports assembly or to some game event or whatever, when we're so passionate that we paint our face and, you know, we scream and we have chants. You know, there was just banter. It was competitive banter. And I think it extended to an already tense relationship. So I don't think it's that deep. I don't think it's that personal. I just think they're, like I said, I think they just don't fuck with each other, and that's fine. They don't have to be besties. But this has definitely brought up, you know, the 2018 sentiment and toxicity. And I really want to tell you guys, whoever is watching this video, my viewers, please don't propagate that toxicity. Just let it go. Laugh about it with your friends. Laugh about it on the internet. Funny, but not hateful, is the sweet spot that we're trying to hit. And with that in mind, let's jump into some tweets. Let's laugh our asses off. We're going to go fast because a lot happened. And let's freaking go. So, last minute update. I'm just gonna read the tweet. Alina, for some reason, is trying to prove in her stories that she won the audience voting. But your team already did a great job and won the standings. What else do you need? So, I went to confirm this information, and there is a story where she has put, like, I think it's like a Facebook poll or a Telegram poll where, you know, you can just click. But from what I understand, the audience voting was also through texting during those 2 hours of the broadcast in both days. So this doesn't have the full picture, but she put it on her story. Guys, can we just let a Terry deal with this? You know, deal with the rivalry that she birthed and then propagated in the media? Can we not get involved? Can we try to be better than this? Can we please? Please. And the fans, we need to be better than this because we can't have Olympics 2.0 level of toxicity. Although we're already there, we just can't have that. We don't have the time. At least I don't have the time and energy.
Guys, I've had to push back this video like 3 times because there's so many updates. But another freaking update. Zhenya apparently retaliated to Alina's Instagram story of her with the audience vote saying, "What's the point if at the end everyone is still shouting Zhenya?" Kind of like saying like, what's the point? I don't know. It means what it means. Both girls are petty. Both girls are obviously tense. And both girls really got into the competitive spirit, which, as we have known for the toxicity of the 2018 and now, doesn't really bring out the best in either of them. So let's just end it there. This is the last update, hopefully, that I will give this week.
So if you didn't see the opening of this wonderful event, you should have, but it was crazy. And they had this dance with capes, and it was a very good idea if everything was very cleanly executed. But there were a lot of failures. One of my favorites was that Evgenia couldn't take it off. So instead of like moving the thing around over her head, she just hurricane with her head. It was really funny to me. I laughed. But one of the things that happened that was kind of unfortunate was that Sasha Trusova fell not once, but twice. And so this tweet very simply says, "Sasha is literally me and life." I had to rewind it because I missed the blue team. The performance was very relatable. It reminds me of our annual Christmas dance project, 30% of our final grade, but we only had an hour to prepare, LMAO. I will say, Alina's opening was impressive. It was organized chaos. Evgenia was just chaotic. So this was crazy. Maya, while spinning, cut her hand, and then she put her hand on her face, like face palming, and then she got blood in her hand, and everybody, Evgenia was just as confused as everybody else, but she wiped it off. But yeah, it was very odd. Yagudin is that annoying grandfather who fucked everyone up, but no one knows how to tell him, how to remove him. Literally, Yagudin was so annoying this entire event, and everybody was just done with his shit. And it was so weird because then he posted a story saying, like, they're calling me an asshole for talking too much. And I'm like, yeah, yes, we are. Alina, mood, take the microphone away from him. This was a moment that the camera captured where Yagudin said obviously something inappropriate because it's him. And Alina was like, can you shut up? What unites us all? Yagudin hate. Can all the Medvedevs and Sagitovs stop hating on each other and start shitting on Yagudin as the girls themselves do? Please? Yes, please and thank you. Mood of the skating season. That was one of the weirdest falls I've seen. Dmitry Aliyev just kind of slipped from under his feet. Something that we learned this weekend is that Misha, Mikhail Kolyada, is very much like Mishin. Help, this is so funny. Both of them were like, mm. And literally it says, has Misha always been so mm, or is he learning from Mishin? So bringing us back to reality, Russians are really entertaining, but they're not really safe. This is probably the worst event of the season in terms of lack of COVID protocols / awareness, and that is saying something. Yeah, like I said, Russians, very entertaining, not very health conscious at all. The moment was Ivan Bukin, who must be protected at all costs. Just look at his face when he catches another star. Protected at all costs. This was very cute. Mishin's trying to assimilate. Fist bump? Fist bump. I found this hilarious when figure skating fans and K-pop fans intersect. Mark, you have the name of my bias. Don't fuck up, Mark. And he didn't. He was my top moment of this weekend, but we'll get to him later. Can I just say that Alina's team had very, very creative ways of like greeting the skaters. They would like get on each other's shoulders. They would like huddle around them. They would. Alina's team was fucking in sync. I respect that. Again, I don't think we're grasping how crazy it was. Were the astronauts just introducing ice skating? Yes, Russia never disappoints. Imagine Zhenya and her team training for the group number. She says Sasha and 5 heads turn. Because she has 5 people in her group that all go by the name of Sasha. This was cute. Sasha, are you happy? Not very. And then look at Plushenko's face. He's like, what do you mean not very? What happened? What's wrong? Conclusion of the day. It Terry, you have one last chance tomorrow. We forgot all the shit anyway. Actually, no, but if you can't even get into the kiss and cry with Medvedeva, pull yourself together, come on. Everybody who was wanting to see, return of Terry and Evgenia kind of got a surprise when Terry did not go into the kiss and cry once. Not even once. For this next tweet, I'm actually going to play it because I need you all to appreciate. Have you experienced the highs and lows of Russian figure skating? Because we thought we had experienced the highs and lows of Russian figure skating that first day. Boy, were we in for a surprise. The highs were high and the lows were lows. Again, the sentiment could not be better said. More things have happened in 3 hours today than the entire Grand Prix circuit of the season. Couldn't agree more. This was honestly such fun. Serious Eurovision vibes. That's the closest thing I can compare it to. Honestly, the production value was over the roof. Can you believe watching the sport is free? I just thought this picture of Anna Shcherbakova was cute. The world needed to see it. There you go. Does anyone know why she looked so down after her last performance after the free? It almost looked like she was crying. Anybody know? Anybody want to fill me in? I love this picture. Honestly, they were also into it. That's like the best part of this competition, was just watching everybody get really into it. And that's what I think happened at the press conference. They just got really into it. Alina and Evgenia just being great leaders, you know, cleaning their area, making it pretty, fixing the uniforms. Programs in Russian figure skating be like BDSM, abuse, psychedelic swan, snake, crazy genius, evil rock, which means evil fate, which is what Trusova is in that Romeo and Juliet skate. Not Juliet, but the evil fate. And all of this in one day. Tutberidze did not look overjoyed with anyone. Anybody know what that? Like, she always smiled when she's like alone at the boards and looks at herself in the camera. But when she saw any score, regardless of what it was, she was like, Do you realize how painful it is to find out that Mark is 17 years old after I presented their wedding video to Medvedeva? If you don't know what this is talking about, it's about the fact that Mark skated, honestly, iconically, like the standout moment of the entire competition, if you ask me. And Evgenia lost her shit and just bawled her eyes out. And, you know, everybody was shipping it, especially because these are the same people which did like a little like partner dance. He needed a girl to fulfill a part, and Evgenia was the next performer, so they just did it together. But it ended up being super cute because now, you know, Evgenia cried at his performance. So here we are, full circle, and everybody ships it. I cannot with them. Everybody in that picture is making an iconic face. So meme-worthy. They all look like Renaissance paintings. Alina really is winning everything in figure skating. Yes, that's my queen, I stan. Honestly, she won even the freaking dog contest at the Tonight Show, and now she's winning the Channel One Cup, and she got every other title. So go ahead, queen, you win that. I'm a puddle now. Same girl, same. That is a cute-ass picture. It doesn't matter which team won. The main thing is how many emotions there were during these days. I've never been so happy since 2019. An unreal atmosphere. This tweet was obviously sent pre-press conference. Oh, when Alina won and her whole team was just shouting Alina. And did you guys see when she was being like thrown in the air? I was scared. I thought she was gonna like fall. I was like, oh my God, this is a Russian competition. Anything can happen. Speaking of press conference, full circle. Yelling from the fact that everyone said that this cup was needed in order to reconcile the sworn rivals. But in the end, it just became Olympics 2.0. And everything just got worse. Drama. Just drama. And yeah, toxicity level over 9,000. Please, guys, don't be part of the toxicity. Oh, this dramatic pause. Guys, if you haven't heard the clip, I'm not going to play it. Maybe I'll play it. I probably won't play it. Well, I really understand the spirit of rivalry and not the desire to pretend that we are friends. I mean, come on, drama. It's funny to me. It's funny to me. I'm not angry at it. When you're divorced but you still hate each other. Pyeongchang 2.0, learn some more, sign, new news feed for 3 more years of discussions and headlines. This press conference is enough, for sure, to live off. 3 more years of discussions and headlines. The silence is too loud. This is like when at the TV show they were asked about the outfit that Evgenia gave to Alina for Don Quixote, because that was Evgenia's outfit, and she just lent it to Alina for the season, an Olympic season, no less. And she ended up, you know, winning in that. So the silence is too loud in all occasions when these two are together. Either it's PR or they really hate each other. Either way, I'm going to cry. This competition's better than an annual event. The media content alone is worth 10 million rubles of prize money. I mean, we did say we wanted some Medvedeva content. Here you go. I've rewatched this like 1,000 times. It just keeps getting more and more hilarious. It's Alina's face that sends me. It's tough. Between this and Evgenia's, you know, cape fail attempt to take off, which turned into like a headbanger, it's hard to guess which one made me laugh more. But I'm not even going to turn that into a competition. That's the last thing we need. Like I said, well, we did ask for some Medo Sagitova moment. And you shall receive. The more I watch this video, the funnier it gets. But also, they both look a bit immature. LMAO, they need to chill. Exactly. They just got too into the competition, and it was already a, you know, a strained relationship. So it got a little elevated. That's all. But on a more serious note, well, everything after the Olympics has surfaced again. In the comments, all the sources about figure skating has just begun to heal, and here it is again. I hope that Alina Sagitova and her patrons have put an end to this mud and dumped in the hell? What? We will no longer see the projects in figure skating next to Zhenya. I'm not sure what they mean, but I do like the sentiment, or I agree with the sentiment of, you know, everything that was for once healing and, you know, it was just so nice to see them beside each other has all gone to shit. And, you know, poop emoji. And the toxicity of 2018, we are at that level right now. But I think it'll die down pretty quick because, again, not a serious competition. And not so much of a serious moment, just a moment nonetheless. Again, back to reality. I'm terrified for the potential ex-skater tested positive for COVID news in about a week. Yeah, this definitely was a super spreader. But again, half of them had COVID, so maybe not. I don't know. Alina and Zhenya both act immature. Stop picking sides, dumbasses. Yeah. You see, guys, when they mixed back up again and started taking pictures together, they're all friends. Let's not get... After the press conference, they were told to, like, pose together, and Evgenia went in for, like, an awkward hug, and Alina was just like, no, we're not hugging. And it resulted in this beautiful, uncomfortable image. When your parents force you to hug your sibling after a fight... I don't know how I feel about this one. There's a feeling with Maya in the Terry's group that is she's an employee of whom they do not want to fire, so they create a condition for them so that they somehow get eliminated. And there was a lot of talk about like her forcing her to do quads she can't do. There is that feeling for sure. I don't know how I feel about that though. And this is the tweet we're ending it on. I don't think it's surprising that Zhenya and Alina don't have much of a relationship. I honestly believe that the friendly rivalry among the Eteri girls was pretty forced and a coping mechanism. I don't think it makes either one of them a bad person. They each have their own friends. And that's fine. And that's how we all need to live. Accepting that they don't have, you know, a bestie relationship, and that's fine and that's okay. And like I said, let Eteri deal with this mess. She created it. So be positive, be nice, and I'll see you guys later.